largest car maker Maruti Suzuki is embarking on a journey towards higher growth and might use Gujarat as a pit stop. How Ronojoy Banerjee is here to tell us exactly that. Ron, so Maruti has also disclosed an ambitious volume guidance. Can you take us through the details?
Well, yes, Maruti has projected a very ambitious volume guidance going into FY18, and it's important because Maruti traditionally has been seen as a conservative company that under-promises but over-delivers. But in this case, they are projecting a 15% volume growth for the year FY18, which is significant because so far Maruti, the commentary we've heard from the management is of about a 10%, 11% growth. What I'm picking up from sources is that at the recently concluded vendors meet that in fact ended earlier today in Singapore, Maruti disclosed a 15-130 strategy. Now, 15 stands for the 15% volume growth in FY18 that I was talking about. 1% stands for the 1 percentage point increase in its market share that it is estimating by the end of this financial year. So the market share currently is at about 47.2, 47.3, but they expect to end at about 48.2, 48.3 by the end of this financial year. And 30 stands for the volume guidance as far as the used car business is concerned. That is true value. But if I were to again pick on the volume growth number, 15% on a really big big base. In FY16, Maruti did its highest ever sales of over 1.5 million. So 15% growth on this, we're talking about a 2,35,000 unit jump, the additional units that Maruti is expecting in FY18. That translates to about 20,000 units a month. So that's quite a, quite a staggering number. And finally, Maruti has also asked their vendors to set up, invest in Gujarat, set up new facilities, for which Maruti has said that they will be facilitating in the process. And they are also going to focus a lot more on tier two towns to improve quality. Those are the key big takeaways from Maruti's just concluded annual supplier meet in Singapore.